Hello guys, so welcome back to this session and let's explore more DW core math functions that we can use in MuleSoft database. So let's go on. So in this session, we are going to talk about different topics. That is, first is math function that we are going to use. Second is minimum. Then the third is max by, and then min by, and for. So here you can see max is basically used to return the highest comparable value in an array. Similarly, minimum is used to return the lowest comparable value in array. And max by, it's what we are going to see. It's actually going to work over an array. Let's say an array of numbers is given and we need to find the highest value among it. So this is the function that we are going to use. So that's very handy, like when we just want to have a set of values and we want to find the max, we're going to use max. But when there is an array, what if we get stuck there? So for that we have max by and min by. Similarly, we have floor. This function will help us to round a number down to the nearest whole number. So this is the topic that we are going to cover. Let's go and make it handy and try it out in the AnyPoint Studio. So here we are in the AnyPoint Studio. I have already created a flow. In earlier topics, we have already discussed how to create a flow and how to add listener and all those things. So please go through the basics to check how we can start working with a flow and create some code. So here I'm going to add some listener so that we can test it using Postman. I've added the listener. Here we need to do the configurations. We have done the setting. Here I'm using slash math because we are going to test the math functions. So here we are, we have configured listener successfully. I'm going to use some transform message so that we can put some sample values over here and see the result. In the upcoming sessions, I'm also going to deal with how we can use, you know, make use of this payload here, define metadata, and use that as a payload and see here in preview. That's something interesting, but we'll cover that in the next class onwards. So let's wait for a while. So here I'm adding transform message. I am going to add some sample value. So I'm using this where a is an object, and here I've used max function. So we need to make in mind how to use the function over here. So we have used max function 1,000. So ideally we know that maximum value should come out of it and it should give us 1,000 as the value. Similarly, the result of this max 1,2,3 will come under b, which is we have used as an object. So this is the different values that I have given over here. Let's quickly set up a payload by using set payload. And it's already there. So let's test it. So I've saved it. Now we need to, since we have not run this, we have to right click over here, go to run as configurations, select the correct project that we're using. Since we are using DataV functions and POC over here, I have to select the correct project and run it. And under console, we should be able to see if it is successfully deployed or not. So let's wait for it. Meanwhile, let's focus on listener. Since we have to test this using Postman, we have set this listener. We need to make path as math. Let's set it in Postman over here. It's opening. So this is also set up. Now let's set. Okay, so this is set up. Let's see if it is deployed in any point studio. Okay, great, it's deployed. Let's test it now. Great. So here we can see that under A, we are getting the response of maximum values that we have. Let's verify it on what values we have given over here. So here for A, max value should be 1 to 1000, 1000 should be the maximum, here 3, and here 3.5. So perfect. So we are able to actually see the value for max. So that's how we do the max function in DW. Let's move forward to max by. Let's see how we iterate over an array and find the maximum value of it. Okay, so max by, what it's going to do is basically it's going to iterate over an array. So here you can see this is an array of elements. So it's going to iterate over an array and return the highest value of the elements from it. And the point over here is that item must be of the same type. It's a very important thing over here. So here you can see we have a list of arrays like A is to 1, A is to 3, A, this is the array. Here we are using max by, and here we are writing item, and we are using item dot A because it's going to iterate over this one, so we have to specify that. So we have to keep in mind the correct format that we need to use while iterating over an array. So here max by will be there, an item will be there, but here we are referring to this A item so that it's iterate over these values. So this is how we are going to do it. Let's test it once again. I've saved it, should be able to see running it over here. From here you can see like it's getting to get deployed, so we can verify that from here. Okay, so it is deployed here. Let's test it. Great, so here we can see that the value is A3, the value that we put up. Or we can put some larger values if font 1000 399 2000. Let's test something different as well quickly. So basically that's how you do it. You use max by to iterate over an array. It's deployed. Let's test it. Great. So the highest is 399. So I'll provide these sample values as well, so that later on during practice you can use yourself and test it and check what kind of value we are getting. Great. So we have covered max and max by. Let's move on to min and min by quickly. Okay, so let's explore for min as a function. So it basically returns the lowest comparable value in an array. So here I've given some example over here. We can see like it's basic object that we are using to test it, like A minimum, B, and these values are given. So let's quickly test it. So we just need to have in mind the perfect function name that we need to use, because like for an object we are using min. But when it comes to find the minimum through a list of an array, we use min by. That's why data weave functions are so important, and it's so important to know each and every function that is present, because it comes very handy. Otherwise, what we'll do is we will go and write min for the iteration over array as well, and it won't work out. So that's why it's very important to go through all the simplest form of data weave functions as well. Okay, so it's deployed. Let's hit and check over here. Great, so we are getting the value as 1.5. Here we can verify that it's 1.5. That's so handy. Let's check quickly for min by. Here I have set up an example for min by, where again we are talking about list, finding the minimum value out of a list of array. So here to iterate over an item, we have iterated over an item, we have put it as item, and we have given the value that needs to iterate over, which is item dot A. This is the correct form that we need to use. So let's test it. It's deployed. This is form min. A equals to 1. Great. So over iterating over this, it has given us the value as 1, which is the minimum. And min by is used for comparing the value when it comes for iteration over an array. Great, this was pretty quick. Let's explore the floor function. Okay, so here I've put up some value for floor. Here we just have to, you know, use floor and the value we need to give. What it does is it rounds a number down to the nearest whole number. Like here we should be getting 1.5 as 1, 2.2 as 2, 3 as 3. However, in case of seal that we used, we would get the highest number. That like seal of 1.5 should give us 2 and something like that. So that's the difference that we can see in floor and seal. And I'll quickly jot down the value for seal as well, so we can test it here. Like you can use seal of this, or what I can do is, let's make it over here only. Let's write seal function 1.5. Here I'm removing this and this. Okay, so it's under array only, and I've put up this value. Let's see what difference we get to see for floor 1.5 and seal 1.5. And if you come across any kind of error over here or data, we will show you, like it was showing earlier. So we need to make sure that before writing any or executing any code, we need to make sure that data is in place. Okay, it's deployed. Let's check. See here, we got 1, 2, 3, 2. So for floor, we get 1.5 value as 1, and for seal 1.5, we get value as 2. So that's what the difference is over here. Okay guys, so we have covered all 3, 4 core DW functions, which have been very simple, but when it comes during use case, it will be very helpful to iterate, to know what functions to use when you have to iterate over an array or a simple object. Hope it was a helpful session. Please comment below if any question or response is needed. It is really great working with you all. Thank you.